Hey guys, so today we're talking about the Sony 16-35 f4 Sony Zeiss lens. So first of all, I want to talk about the build quality. It's made of metal, so it's pretty solid. I added this tape on it just because it scratches really easily. And I found this on YouTube. Somebody suggested putting this type of tape. And if you're interested in finding out where I got it from, I will put a link in the description below. It's just going to prolong it longer and from getting it scratched. This, so far, it's a solid build. I really love it. So compared to the G Master 16-35 2.8 lens, that one comes in around a little over $2,000. And this one was $1,300, I think, maybe $1,398, but I bought it on eBay for $800. So if you could find it on eBay used, since this has been out for a while, you could probably find it between $8,000 to $1,000 was the going rate on eBay. And I thought that's a pretty good price for this lens. Opening it up to 16, I haven't experienced that ever. So this is my first wide angle lens. You'll see, I'll show you some pictures really quickly of how I shot some of my portraits at 16 wide. I mostly stick to 24 millimeter. That seems to be a really sweet spot for me on this lens. I haven't really gone up to 35 too much, but it has done a pretty good job at 35 millimeters as well. So you might be asking, what is this lens for? Well, this is mostly for environmental portraits, anything architecture, real estate, landscapes. That's what this lens is for. I've used it for some portraits, but not like headshot portraits, something where I'm getting the wide element of the background in. And that's what I use this for. And so far it's come out really sharp. I really love the way it looks. It looks great at 16, it looks great at 24. And those are the 2 millimeters that I stick to. So one of the few cons of this lens is it is a little bit heavy, not too heavy though. It is an f4 lens, so you're not gonna be able to use it in low light, but this is something you're gonna use outdoors anyways. You're not gonna use this for any indoor shots. If you are, you might wanna just get an LED light to compensate for the low light. I'm gonna use this lens mostly for outdoors, or if I'm doing real estate, I can always stop down the shutter on this. It's gonna be on a tripod anyway, so I can let a lot of light in no matter what. So anyways, guys, this is a great lens, and if you do find yourself in the market for something wide, I would recommend getting this one. It is a solid build, its focus is really great, and if you can find it for $1,000, it's a steal. That is it. I will catch you guys in the next video. Later.